I'm Dr. James Chappius. I'm an orthopedic spine surgeon at Spine Center Atlanta, and we're here today to talk to you a little bit about the spine, pedicle screws, pedicles. I thought this could be informative for a lot of people who've had this operation, maybe still painful, or people that are patients that are about to have the operation and want to learn more about it. So basically, this is a pedicle screw. There's three on each side. They're connected to a side connector and a rod. These screws are placed down the pedicle of the spine, which is the pillar of the spine, and it goes into the vertebral body. They were developed in the 60s and 70s, started to be used commonly in the United States, probably in the 80s, 90s, and they're primarily used for lumbar fusions, fractures, or deformity or scoliosis. So those are the more common uses for them. Probably they're used more often than not for lumbar disc herniation, spinal instability, degenerative disc disease. Why might your surgeon want to use these? After he's decompressed or taken pressure off your spinal cord or spinal nerves, he may need to stabilize your back or spine because there could be movement after that. Now, the spine can be stabilized or fused in a lot of different ways. It can be done from the front or anteriorly, and that would be known as an ALIF or an anterior lumbar interbody fusion. It could be done from the side, and that's a couple different procedures are done there, but it's called a trans-psoas approach, where a device is placed interbody like this, but it's done from the side. This is an ALIF, or an anterior lumbar interbody fusion. And then many times, those procedures are backed up with pedicle screws, or they're put on the back part of the spine to stabilize things. Now, if your fusion's done from the back, generally your surgeon will do what's called a TLIF or PLIF procedure. A TLIF is called a transforaminal lumbar interbody fusion. And that's because when he does the decompression and opens this up, he puts the interbody device through the neuroforamen into the interbody space and usually does either one on one side. And it could be horseshoe shaped, so it takes up more surface area. Or it could be done on each side, and that would be called a PLIF, or a posterior lumbar interbody fusion. After those devices are put in, there's bone graft put in the center, and then these pedicle screws are put in to stabilize this. Now the question is, after you've had surgery with a pedicle screw, are they painful? Do they need to come out? The original FDA clearance for pedicle screws was for the temporary fixation of the lumbar spine. Now, most surgeons, including myself, when you use these, would not take them out unless they become problematic. How could they become problematic? First of all, when they're put in, if they're malpositioned, they can cause pain from irritation of the nerve root at the associated level. And so if the pedicle screw was placed in here, but it was malpositioned, it could irritate the nerve root. How would you know that? Generally, that's something that presents immediately post-op. Secondly, they can become painful because of loosening. Do pedicle screws loosen? Yes. And it depends on the nature of the bone. If there's more osteoporosis, they can loosen at an alarming rate of up to 30-40%. Now, once they've done their job in the fusion solid, there really isn't a need for those, but there's no reason to have another operation if they're not giving you problems. If you are continuing to have back pain, or back and leg pain after a spinal fusion using pedicle screws, what can be done? Well, the first thing is we need to find out if your fusion solid and where are your pedicle screws? That's generally done with a CT scan. Now, we hear a lot about MRI scans, and a lot of times I like to see both because sometimes there can be pain at the level above or below your fusion. That's called adjacent segment disease. But in order to evaluate the position of the pedicle screws and whether your fusion's solid, that's generally done with a CT scan. Now, if you've got significant leg pain along with that, many times your surgeon might recommend a myelogram with a post-myelogram CT. The myelogram is where water-soluble dye is injected into your spinal sac. This is done by a radiologist, and then a CT scan is done after that. So with that type of study, not only can you tell where your screws are, you can look and see where the neuroforamen or the nerve roots come out and whether or not they're compressed. So once that's done, if it's determined that your fusion's solid, next the question, and there's not malpositioned screws, then are they loose? That can be determined by usually the axial cut CT scan. You can see a lucency around the pedicle screws. Now, just because you see that doesn't necessarily mean that they're painful. But if I see that in a patient, they're still in pain, I ruled out problems at the level above or below the fusion, the CT scan showed me that the fusion's solid, then a lot of times I'll talk to the patients about pedicle screw removal. How do we know if it's going to help? Well, the biggest way I like to determine that, and it's not 100%, but we do what's called a hardware block. If we've determined that the fusion's solid, there's not a problem above or below the fusion at another disc level, then we've got a CT scan again that shows the fusion solid, then what we can do to help determine whether or not the pedicle screw itself is the source of pain, we have our interventional spine docs inject a local anesthetic around the screws. That's done in the operating room under IV sedation, and then we get them up and walk them around. If the pain is improved, again, not 100%, but it helps to prognostically to say, yeah, this could be helpful. Then what we do is bring a patient to our surgery center, they're put to sleep, and we make an incision generally through where the other incision was, identify the screws and remove them. Now, the other thing we do at that time is we do evoked EMG stimulation of the pedicle screw. So that's done with an EMG technician who's in the room at the time of surgery. And we run a current, milliamp current, through the screw. And we run a milliamp current up to 30 milliamps. If the screw is positioned appropriately, not malpositioned on a nerve root, then you should get 20, 25, 30 milliamps. So if the screw stimulates at lower than that, say 5 or 6 milliamps, that tends to indicate that the screw is touching or very close to one of the nerve roots, which could be the source of leg pain with a patient. So once the screws then are removed, we stimulate the screw hole. And what we're interested in is the medial and inferior, or the inside and lower part of the pedicle screw, because that's where the nerve root associated with that pedicle lives. And if we stimulate there and we get a response at 2, 3, 4, 5 milliamps, what that tells us is the screw either violated the pedicle wall or over time had eroded the pedicle wall to where that could be painful. And generally what I've seen when those screws are removed, patients' leg symptoms improve a lot. So the last thing we do once we've removed the screws is we determine, we look, even though the CT scan suggested the fusion solid, we actually look at the fusion and determine that it's solid. Now if it's not solid, then we can do one or two things. You can leave the pedicle screws in. If they're loosened, replace those with a little bit larger screw, or you can burr up or rough up the previous fusion, clean up any pseudoarthrosis, which tends to look like scar tissue, add more bone graft or infuse BMP, which is bone morphogenic protein. What I generally do while I'm there is I say, let's take the screws out, let's augment the fusion, and most of the time, there's not a need for anything further. So that's just a basic discussion of pedicle screws. We'll have another talk coming soon, but this one is just to give you a little idea of what they are, and they're a great device. They're known as spinal instrumentation, but they can be painful after surgery, and there is something that can be done about that.